It is my great pleasure to be here to share some news from biology today with you. So your life and mine start with this. The union of sperm and egg. The fertilization involves sperm from the father and egg from the mother. They meet in the usual way and fertilize the egg, acquire the potential to give rise to the individuals like you and me. If you trace back your generation, you are derived from your parents, and your parents are derived from your grandparents, and so on, in distant past. This perpetuity can only be achieved through what biologists like me call germ cell lineage. These are the only cells that are immortal among more than 200 types of cells in your body. The rest die with you. So these immortal germ cells called gametes are very important, and we call them germline. In our society, this unbroken line is under threat. The present generations are having children later and later, and the older germ cells are less likely to result in successful fertilization, which leads to the declining birth rate. It's not just the people. The continuous decrease in the reproductive rate of large livestock has resulted in huge economic losses. Setting aside human needs, there are endangered animals down to few individuals. How can we preserve them? That is where the assisted reproductive technology offered hope. Since Robert Edwards successfully combined human germ cells in the dish, more than 12 million babies have been born through this technology called in vitro fertilization. However, current assisted reproductive technology can only be applied if sperm and egg can be obtained from the body. If not, there are no options available. But I would ask now, can we create a germ cell in a dish? So this is a question. So let's start with how the germ cells are formed in the body. After fertilization, fertilized egg undergoes cell divisions and differentiates into the different cell types. As it further developed, original cells or eventual sperm and egg known as the primordial germ cell emerge. Then these primordial germ cells then differentiate into the primary egg, known as the oocyte in the female, or spermatogonia, the precursor of the sperm in the male. These egg and sperm mature over time, which is associated with the sexual maturation of individuals. Now imagine, if this entire process were to occur outside the body. So my team and I have been focusing on replicating this entire process in the dish, known as in vitro gametogenesis. The key to generating the germ cell in the dish is a type of cells called pluripotent stem cells, because they each have an ability to differentiate into any cell type in the body. Martin Evans showed that such a pluripotent stem cell could be derived from pre-implantation embryo in mice, and James Thompson showed it could be done in human. Based on these breakthroughs, Shinya Yamanaka showed that any kind of cell in the body could be turned into the pluripotent stem cells simply by expressing a specific set of proteins. These are called induced pluripotent stem cells, and they possess the same potential as those derived from the embryos. By using these pluripotent stem cells, we can hijack the germline. During normal development, cells receive the signal that guides their differentiation into the different cell type. By mimicking light signals, pluripotent stem cells can be directed along the pathway to differentiate into the egg and sperm. This has been successfully demonstrated in our laboratory by using mouse pluripotent stem cells. By providing appropriate signals, we were able to generate mature egg from mouse pluripotent stem cells. Also, to achieve this, we created a mini ovary from pluripotent stem cells, allowing the oocyte to mature outside the body. Importantly, eggs produced in a dish are capable of the fertilization and giving rise to yet more mice like this. These look the same as any other mice. They grow up, they eat the food, they breed, and live long. But in this case, genetic mother of these mice is the pluripotent stem cell growing in a dish. With this in vitro gametogenesis, the process of creating an egg require only skin cells or other easily collectible cells from the body. even cells in the urine. So this means, actually, this kind of technology can be applied to the various mammalian species, including humans, livestock, or even endangered animals. Several research groups have successfully produced the primordial germ cell from pluripotent stem cells in all these cases. Notably, our laboratory is actively involved in the depopulation effort for the northern white rhinoceros. Sadly, there are only two females who remain on this planet. We have generated the egg precursors from the northern white rhinoceros in these pluripotent stem cells, and then currently creating a mini ovary system to mature these precursors into the eggs. But we can go further than it. By using this technology, we can skip the sex-dependent reproduction. Today, germ cells have different shape and different function based on the sex. This difference is genetically made by the sex chromosome. In the human, male have an X and Y chromosome, and the female have two X chromosomes. From a genetic viewpoint, this is the only difference between male and female. But in a dish, we can eliminate this difference. So our laboratory succeeded in the switching from the XY chromosome to the XX chromosome. How did we do that? Well, we took the skin cell from the male mice and they made an induced pluripotent stem cell, which have X and Y chromosome, of course. Then we made a lot of these cells. In some rare population, unequal segregation of sex chromosome occur during cell division, which means some XY chromosome become one X chromosome that then double and become two X chromosomes. We picked up a very rare population of these cells that have a two X chromosome, and we made an egg. The egg derived from sex-converted induced pluripotent stem cells behave exactly egg from traditional females. We then fertilize sex-converted egg with the sperm, and this gives rise to typical healthy mice like this. They grow up, they eat the food, they mate, and live long, just like conventional bred mice. The only difference is these are derived from two dads. Looking at the history of reproductive technology like this, technology is developed in the experimental animal like this, can eventually be applied to the human and other animals. Today, the production of egg in the dish, even from traditional male cells, opens a new possibility for the reproduction in the future. We can create a germ cell in the dish, and they can come from two fathers, two mothers, or perhaps other combinations. Thank you.